peoplefirsttanktv.com. Did an update of the freshwater tanks. I thought it would be best after doing a wee update of the saltwater tank as well. So I've only got the two tanks set up, so won't take long. I've got a couple of fish in here just now. I've got two just common clownfish, and I've got a spangled goby. Probably won't be able to show you him because he hides. He's dug one of us out. It hides either down the back here on the left or in this wee bit. The tank's doing pretty well. Had a bit of a problem with algae, but I'm kind of getting on top of it now. Doing kind of more water changes. Don't think I was doing enough water changes. But I'm doing them kind of water change once a fortnight now, and it's kind of getting rid of the algae. The corals have all done pretty well. I've got these kind of, what are called, candy cane corals, I think they're called. Probably wrong with that name right enough. And I've been able to frag these ones and these ones off them. It seemed to be growing quite quick. It had like about four heads on it when I got it. When I split this off from it, I fragged this off it, it only had two heads, and one of the heads is splitting into two now. And this one was just a single head, which is now splitting as well. So it seems to be growing quite well. I've also got some, if you can see for the reflection, star bulb. I've got a clump here and a decent amount here as well. So it's doing not too bad. And I've got a fungi plate. It seems to have grew as well. It kind of moves itself about. Sometimes it's kind of up here, moves itself across, moves itself up and down. It's moved itself right into this corner, kind of up against, right up against the glass. Sometimes its tentacles are really kind of right into his body, and other times it's kind of sets him for food. They're right out like this. And I've got a hammer coral here, which is where all the shells seem to kind of gather, or the old shells. Coral seems to be doing pretty well, but to be honest, if you think there's anything wrong, I'm not 100% on the marine tanks yet myself. If you see anything wrong, can I tell me in the comments so I can fix the problem? Quite a lot of these, it's not out just now. Fan worms. There's one there. It came on the live rock, kind of growing everywhere and anywhere. A kind of filter feeder. And I'll show you the sump now. I had custom built from Macro Parade. It's just three chambers. Got a return line here. Then the power head is actually kind of runs from the overflow to stop it from, because I hang on overflow up the top here. It stops it from breaking the siphon and getting a kind of air stuck in it. And I've just got a 100 watt heater. This red algae keeps growing the last month. It's taken over the chato, so I don't really know what's happening there. I'm going to try and scrape it all out, clean out the chato, and hopefully it'll sort the problem. And then I've just got a return pump here, and it's 1200 litre per hour, I think. I need to top my tank up a bit. I did get a auto top off system, but it doesn't really work too well. It takes forever to top it back up, and it doesn't work right in my opinion. A skimmer, which I'm going to put in soon. It keeps sliding down the glass, so I'm going to have to work out some sort of box section or something, maybe to make a crate to actually hold it up and stop it. Can I, if it goes below the level, it's not going to work right. And then hopefully that will start kind of reducing the algae problem as well. I'll just get it running on one of these little fluvo lights here. They're okay, but they're kind of long for a... If I've got it straight, it actually sticks out by where the door would be. But it does the job. The stand I made myself. Looks okay. If the camera would focus. Just made it out of 2x4s and some plywood. And stuck a little handle onto there. I don't really know why my camera won't focus. The stand looks alright. Got a couple of cleaner shrimp in here as well. Got a lot of seraph snails and hermit crabs. Hermit crab at the back there, just hiding. I've got about 5 or 6 hermit crabs and 10 seraph snails. There's a seraph snail here. They kind of burrow into the sand and get any leftover food and stuff like that. Absolutely hate this overflow box. I've actually had to prop it up higher because it lowers the water level by about 4 inches. I've got to have a pump running on constantly to keep the siphon going. If you're supposed to be able to just shut this off and leave it once you've made a siphon, but after a couple of days the siphon breaks and your tank overflows, which actually had happened quite a few times now. So I've got to run a dip out ahead in the sump you've seen. Got to have that running constantly for it to actually work properly. It's pretty unsightly, so I'm actually going to get a new display tank made from a place called DC Aquariums, a custom build aquarium. So I'm going to get a display tank made from them with a built in overflow and built in return lines. It should be a lot better. And I've just got this little light here. It's from All Pond Solutions. Couple of switches for the different colour variants. We've got three blue and 3 white, but it's also got another switch for 4 blue LEDs, which are actually pretty bright. Give a really good shimmering effect. Give the corals really fluorescent colours. Yep. Comment, rate and subscribe.